meat stew. Let me flizzle this. Flizzle, flip this around. And let me check that I am in focus. I think I'm pretty much in focus. So anyway, guys, what's going on? It's Oakley here. Got a little bit of a vlog for you guys today. I was going to have a different video out for you guys tonight. However, it took me a grand total of like 3 hours to get my car head unit finished, fitted. I'll quickly go and show you how it looks now. And I will also take these out in the meantime. I think I've got my house keys. I have. Perfect. So shut that door. Just so as it actually shuts properly is nice. Don't want to waste heating or anything like that. Get into the motor, like so. You've got a really nice view of my garage there. For you garage fans, you garage fanatics. Oh, that was a horrible, horrible pose to have. Get in, hopefully the light stays on. Is it going to stay on or will it turn off? Who knows? Let's get you in, turn you on. It's going to go off. Bang, don't worry, we're on it. So these are just like some cable things for the head unit. So yeah, I've got the head unit. Let me just spin this around again so I can show you. So yeah, it took 3 hours because there's so much stuff they had to add in. Got my Dr. Pepper Zero here. As you guys know, for Lent, I gave up full fat fizzy drinks. I also bought, what the heck was that? Okay, that was that on the head unit. So anyway, this thing here, it's like a drink holder. They're like, it's really snazzy actually. If I can do this one-handed, yes I can. You can like, it folds up like that, and it's meant to, these like this are the back, so it's meant to clip in like this way. You press these buttons, boom! And it opens up very slowly. Slow motion. Okay, so that's that. Bought it, because it's meant to like, oh, that's the head unit flip, I've already shown you. It's meant to go in there, but basically it knocks down too much. That was a waste of a buy. But yeah, this is the head unit I got. Going to focus for you in now. Really, really nice, really happy with it. It's a Sony one. Got a pretty killer deal on it actually. Took a freaking long time to fit. 3 hours. This is that little fascia plastic thing that I told you about the other day. It cost 45 quid, I think it was, if I remember correctly. This bad boy had to, because the BMWs don't make it easy. They don't make it easy to fit stuff in. It was missing a freaking Farcra wire or some crap which cost 20 quid. Then there's another freaking wire that cost like £50 or something apparently. I don't know if it's £50 for this one wire. There's like loads of things I had to buy to basically make this work. But it does work really well now. I would show you how it sounds, but I haven't got my phone on me and I don't want to risk like copyright music and all that sort of stuff. But it sounds really, really nice. And it looks nice as well. It's nice to have like a different, because the standard head unit in this car is like not amazing. And it also, BMW's, the way their speakers work out, there's a speaker there. You won't be able to see it. There's a speaker just above it, like basically where my finger is there. I've got like a sub underneath the seats, and it's got like a speakers behind it. Basically the way it works is that it's all tuned in together, and the actual head unit they have here is not very powerful, so if you go too loud with it, it just sounds horrible and distorted. With this, it's like really, it's like, I think it's like 3 times the wattage. That's so funny. The wattage is like 3 times better in this bad boy than it is for the standard head unit, so I'm really, really happy with it. I'm yet to figure out how on earth I actually take it out of the, I think this is the eject button, but doesn't want to eject. I think this bit here is blocking it from coming off. I'm not even gonna bother trying right now. I just did another like attempt doing this video, but failed so epically because I couldn't eject. I spent like 35 seconds just like, why won't you eject? So it wouldn't come out. But the thing is though, it has to come out because they give me this snazzy little box, like a snazzy little Sony box. And you know, it's got freaking, if you just push it, it opens, boom. Open with one hand. It's got this nice little spongy, I can't touch it, spongy thing here. This is actually the same material that I used to make my own little pop filter on my microphone. But yeah, really happy with that. 3 hours, you know, it's not the best thing in the world. However, oh no way. Oh freaking heck, I had like a business card for the guy who actually fitted this. It was gonna cost me so much more money. I think the final bill was like £120 more, 120 something pound more than I thought it was going to be. Set me up big time. Like he sorted me out big time. So massive thanks to him. I'll do a video about it. Like for you guys who are like looking for, you know, having your stereos fitted or whatever, and you live in like the Hertfordshire area, he does like call outs. He only works for Halfords like 2 days a week or something. So I'll put a link to his website thing in the description of a future video once I've got like talking to him a little bit more. He's a really nice chap, really helped me out with this, and it's actually great and it sounds amazing. I am yet to figure out how, if any of you guys actually have this device, this head unit, let me know in the comments how I freaking make the phone calls work. I mean, I can stream my Bluetooth, like my Bluetooth thing works absolutely fine. The only thing that doesn't work that well, let me just get this back on my face, the only thing that doesn't work that well, well, doesn't work at all in fact, I can't hear anything, is the calling, when I call people, it doesn't seem to want to work for whatever reason it may be. I think I'm slightly out of focus, but just get my house keys out. This is a bit of a update vlog thing, I guess you could say. I did want to do a video that, there we go, now I'm focused. I wanted to do this video that I saw Vicstar do the other day, where he was, like, he went into a free-for-all on Black Ops 2, using Tomahawks only on combat axes, whatever they're called. But however, I just didn't get around to doing it, obviously, because I was there since literally 4:45, and I've got in about 5-10 minutes ago. I just put that stew in the microwave. So yeah, about 3 hours just waiting for this thing to be fitted, because there's just so many freaking add-ons. It got to the point where he just like let me like use a staff room chair as a seat, because there's no seats in half. It's pretty nice of him. So I was just sat like looking at the paints, just like, what are you going to do? Anyway, guys, that's it for now. 500th video is like 2 videos away now. So you've got 1 video tomorrow, then my 500th video on Thursday, I think. So hopefully that should be pretty cool. Hopefully you guys are pretty excited for that. If you missed my video from yesterday, there'll be a link to it in the description as always. My Twitter will be down there as well. I've been OakleFish. You guys have been awesome. Thank you very much for watching, and goodbye. Oh, ew. Almost forgot the ew.